Hi guys, welcome back to another episode of Saloon Talk. It is season 3 and we are bigger and better than before. For all of you who have been catching up the show all the way from episode 1, we have been talking about different topics that are happening in our lives today. Very many of you are not aware of the things that are going on in your life, but tune in to Saloon Talk every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. We're going to be talking about different topics that happen in your life and giving you solutions so that you out there and you're stranded, we are going to be your book guide, your cover to the life that you want to live. In the building right now, we are at Spectra Saloon Bukolobi. If you know you want a face bit, a hair bit, whatever you want to do, as long as it's self-care, they have everything right here. If you want to do your nails, if you want to do your hair, if you're a man and you want to cut your beard, they have it right here at Spectra Saloon in Bukolobi. I'm joined in by three lovely people all the way from the music industry, and we're going to be talking about the topic of divorce and property sharing. So before we start with the topic, I'm going to my guests are going to introduce themselves and what they do, and also answer me a simple question: are you married or you're not? Okay, let us start with the man himself in the blue. He's going to introduce himself. I do not want to spoil things.
Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Saint Nelly Said Nsubuga, aka Chikola Sense, aka Kakubidewa, a Ugandan hip hop artist, a freestyle MC, a storyteller, a Luga Flow revolutionary activist, Mchizimbi, Chikola Sense.
Abeha, but then you know, come Kaluga Flower. Okay, just one sample before we go.
To the band about one of Mateka Batuzali Dawano, Netuavlan to Yengen for Muru Jarawano, but waiting get a dangabatu Gambanga Itawano, go Wakabi Muduro and Gurobu Gobabutano, Kakebe, but was the Nyanganga Banji Baduka Mateka, while the only no Kuvao and Away Quake and Gatepo, Gamuno Wakunonia, Nonia Nabu Dangabo, Gedambo Saint in the Lisa Diako Kagobaku, Munanga, but to tutandika gwe show tutuse bugolobi ku Spectra Saloon zanze yo gwa bakavi mwana watu abakavi deva legend zingoli mwato wakavi kayondo tazena nyondo naenze na waraga wakavi waneno kukono biniganta ngeda bomanyi siteda kulwa munsobi nengamba kazi dalo kankagabe yenze wakavi.
Wow, okay. I think I should also learn how to freestyle because people are always asking. So I'm like, okay, let me go to the man on my right before we go to the beautiful lady herself. First, introduce yourself and what you do.
Yeah, greetings to the world. It's original, real and proper, Mr. Benny Gonta. I wanna greet you in the name of Jesus because it's a Sunday, you know. Yeah, blessings in the name of Jesus. My name is Benny Gonta, a dancer artist. Straight out of Gonta City, you know, we think. But
yeah,
but
yeah,
it's over, so, brother.
Yeah, yeah. Kwekava Spectra Saloon, we got it all. We got it all. Then the beautiful lady herself, I wanted you to be the last because they always say ladies first. But here, ladies are the most important. So we come last after the men, you know.
Ladies last.
Hi, what's up, everyone? My name is Leila Kayondo. Your girl, Leila Kayondo. I'm an artist. What else should I tell you? Singa namanya, sandi kwaga desani kumba day, now we shine you.
Okay, but before, because the men did not tell us whether they are married or not. So first of all, are you married?
No, I'm not married. Okay. I've never been married, but I would want to get married one day. Yeah.
That's every girl's wish. Are you married, Benigan?
I'm with someone.
So it's not marriage, it's not complicated, no, but...
It's not complicated, it's to the ring journey.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Okay. Saint Nelly, are you married?
I have someone. I live with someone, and I have a family, but not legally married in Mubia Church. But Ningali married Muko.
Of course. Actually, so now what we are going to do, since Leila is single and she's not married, like I said, the topic today is divorce and property sharing. Very many of you, those who do not know what divorce is separation between a man and a woman. Ngamwa, you guys came together, you got married, but now things did not go the way you planned and you ended up going your separate ways. Most people divorce when they do not have any kids. But others divorce when they have kids. Those who have kids become co-parents. Those who do not have Nah, it depends on where your relationship, like how your relationship was and where it took you. So if you divorce without kids, most cases you don't talk again. You don't. So divorce in Uganda, actually, divorce is very, very big. It is very, very wide. Very many people don't call it divorce. Others just be like separation, but it's actually divorce. Many people in Uganda today or worldwide, they get married just because of love. Oh, I love this guy. Not knowing that marriage comes with a lot of things. So when it comes to the topic of divorce and property sharing, there is a trending story going on all over social media. It was 5 days ago. A very famous Moroccan footballer. He divorced with his model wife. They were together for some time. They have two kids, two beautiful kids. And now they decided to end their marriage and they got a divorce. So in when it comes to divorce, those who are very aware of the divorce laws or the marriage laws, there is what we call a prenup. This is something, a statement or a document you're supposed to sign before you sign your marriage certificate. This ensures the property that you earn or the one that you, the man earns, whatever property that you are having, your own personal property, remains yours. Most cases, people who get married and they do not sign prenups, this is where we have issues. Oh, mkazi yazana nziba kwa budichimuchenina. Why would you get married without signing a prenup? And in Ugandan laws, prenup is actually there. But very many people are not aware of it. Others don't care. I'm in love, I'm being taken. Others are taken by social media. You fall in love with a don, he proposes. Who are you to ask for prenup? Obviously, you just go and enjoy the money. So today we're going to be talking about the divorce and the property sharing mainly. Okay, let me start with Leila. Are you from a divorced family or you are from a stable family?
I'm very lucky to come from a very stable family. Growing up, my dad was always around my mom, and they love each other, and till they passed away. So I'm going to understand divorce as you've defined it, and I'm going to understand divorce of, like, I mean, from things that I hear or watch, but I do not really know what it, what divorce is. But I want to understand it is divorce is when, like, maybe like you're married, and then with so many things that happen in a relationship, and you have, I mean, to go separate ways, whether you have kids or not, you just can't stand each other anymore, and then you get divorced. For example, I'm not married, but I've been in a relationship, and a serious relationship, and then when we had to separate, literally, I didn't ask for anything, and he didn't even have to give me anything, because we didn't talk about it. So, I don't really know how you can sit your partner down and say this is what we'll share when we separate. yeah, but some things are just that, like that in life. For those that are married or in a relationship, know that it's very hard to sit your partner down and say, I want us to share this when, I mean, to have half of this when I leave. If you want to divorce, you have to divorce. Because, I mean, why stay in a toxic, bad relationship?
Mm-hmm. Anyway, that's true, but most cases, like you've said, most cases, most cases, prenups are like the ground to which you're going to, because there are some things that you earn or that you get while you are married, or there are some things, not like if you're married with someone, you have a business, and you're like, oh, we're going to be with this business, you're going to share, and you guys started it up together. When you're divorced, no one is going to take more the whole thing. You guys have to sit down and be like, who invested more? Who is taking what? You get, because the more you invest, anyway, it's funny because the law.
It's very hard. For me, I feel like it's very hard. Do you know what love is, man?
well, I think I know, but I'm not sure if I know.
It's love, it's not a business. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you can't really approach someone in that kind of way when you're in love, man. I mean, like, mm-hmm. We are trying to have a good time, and then you're talking about that time when we end this. Then why are we even here, mm-hmm. if we know we are going to even end? Because love is a thing of hope. Love is a thing of faith. Same way it's like believing in God, because with love you sacrifice a lot. And there are things that are not going to be in your way, but because of love, you have to do them. And our parents have done them. Our mothers, our fathers have had to go an extra mile for us to survive. So this kind of talking about relationships in a kind of way of like it was written by a white man and then we have to read and follow, I feel like it's unrealistic. It's very hard. Just like Laila said, you can't be in a relationship and you start saying, now when we separate, because your mind will just run and you're like, fuck, there's going to be a time when we separate. Oh, no.
But actually, yeah, to catch you guys right, it is actually very true. It's like being in love. You guys are head over heels over each other. Yes, the prenups are there and all that. You want to be safe. But sometimes, by the way, sometimes you be wanting to ask. But you're like, cut if I ask, and he's like, what if now you don't want to marry me? You're only thinking of your property. And like most people actually are scared. They want to ask because now in this case, most times in Uganda today, we have relationships whereby Omuntu, Omukazi, like she's no longer gotten from home when she has nothing. She comes to you and you guys are in a relationship where she has a business of her own. She has something, like her own standing. So most cases, these girls, when they get into marriage or relationship, like really long-term relationships, marriage-like relationships like these two are having, you end up feeling already betrothed to the person. You don't want to ask for this. You end up doing things that you don't want just because you want to make the other person happy. So I don't really get it. So anyway,
but maybe it still comes back to sacrifice because it is love. Love is for two people.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not supposed to be one-sided thing, and that's how things go wrong because now people are putting love in a perspective of a business. Yeah. It's more of a business, and yet you could be with a partner. This year you don't have a job, and your partner has a job, and then next year you get a job. And you're all working. So why are you in a relationship? You're in a relationship to build a family.
Yeah. And
so
also,
when you have children, it's not about the two of you. Actually, this is how I see it for me.
Yeah.
Okay, first
it's
wait.
It's about the parents.
Yeah.
When
okay.
you have children, it's about the kids.
Okay, let me catch you guys right there. Let us go to a small commercial break. When we come back, we're going to start with Saint Deli with his opinion on what divorce and property sharing is all about. Let us come back. Welcome back to the show. You're still watching Saloon Talk. I'm your girl, Savaria. Here's AKA Wild and Free. And today we're talking about the topic of divorce and property sharing. We are still here at Spectra Saloon in Bukolobi. I told you, if you want to get a first beat, if you want to self-care yourself, just come right down here to Spectra Saloon in Bukolobi. They're going to work on you just right. So, Saint Deli, before we went for the commercial break, you're about to tell us about your perspective of divorce and property sharing.
Thank you. One thing I wanted to talk about is these things of divorce and property sharing don't really work in Africa. Because first of all, most of us are hustlers. There's no way you're going to meet someone, you are in a very good relationship, love is in the air, and then you start talking about this sign somewhere, if we separate, we shall share this. What are you going to share? The only thing I have
like
is a fridge, is a TV, sofa sets. I mean, these things are common outside Africa because they have properties.
Sure.
And so many ladies are using it as an opportunity to get rich. Everyone is talking about Hakimi, Hakimi this, Hakimi that, but no one is asking why are they separating. Was it a toxic relationship? Was it, maybe she had different intentions.
But you know, as Ugandans, for them, once they hear, Mwau Kanye, it was never like that, you know?
Yeah.
Like people are exposed.
Yeah, I understand. But a few years ago, I was in Europe, and I realized that so many girls are making it a business to get married to rich white men, and then later they divorce to get money. But here in Africa, it is very hard for some, unless someone is getting married to a loaded guy, that's when they sign somewhere that at the end of the day, if we are to separate, you'll take this, I'll take that. So it will be very difficult for us to... Yes, the law is there, but some of us get married because we are deep in love. Like, you don't even think about... Actually, me, I've never thought of separating with my girl, with my woman, because... the way I see things, right now we have a kid together, that even if we separate, even if we wake up one day and separate, I'll still have to contribute something because she has my child. So we are not, it's not necessarily that we are supposed to sign anywhere or somewhere that if we separate, you'll take this and this. Okay, you'll take a fridge and a TV, then what? I'll
one
still have to provide
pillow,
for my child, for my daughter. You understand?
Yeah,
so when you go deep into this, the only thing you have to look at is responsibility as a man, as an African man. Because, yes, I know sometimes you meet when you're hustlers, then you work hard, you start buying properties, you start building. I know. But at the end of the day, if you have some magazine, you have kids together, it's always your responsibility to provide. You know, and sometimes I think it depends on the way you separate.
Yeah,
because me, I believe that even if you don't have a child or children together and you see that someone is struggling out there, you can still help where you can, you know.
Yeah.
So it shouldn't be the law, that following the law that, yes, let's sit. I have a TV, you know. Some of these things are for rich people.
I feel like relationship things are not supposed to be about... No.
Scripted. So many men here are going to Kutomera, that my mother. But some of our mothers are not trusted.
Yeah, but they all resemble the boys and their mothers are like best.
Yeah, it's
friends.
A good thing, actually. It is a very good thing because that's your blood.
Yeah.
But everything. You see, people like Akimi, they earn a lot of money.
Excuses for Akimi's act. We are going to find excuses and
yes.
reasons. Everyone is going to give their opinion. But at the end of the day, when you're separating with your partner, it has to be a fight. There's no good separation. It has to be a fight. Separation
yeah.
is separation.
True.
But then, at the same time, I would never and never support Akim. Like, you're in a relationship with someone. Why leave her on zero? I mean, she's given you kids. She's
that's why we need to listen to the other side of
yeah.
the story.
Okay, it doesn't even matter what side. Maybe he had a trauma or from his past, or maybe the lady wasn't nice to him all this time. But then you are with me, right? You're with me, and we are raising kids together. I am wasting your time as much as you're wasting my time. At least let's share something while you're living. Or
yeah.
while we...
well, yeah, I'll actually support that very much. But in Hakim's case, his wife is a professional model.
Yes.
So she has her money.
Mm-hmm.
And
some
also,
money.
Yeah, some money, okay. And when they were separating, she did not ask for half. She asked for all his property. So now, this comes to women who marry people, and you just want property.
No,
okay, we didn't know what actually went on.
What was going on in that relationship?
That's true.
Already.
Yeah.
Hakim knew what was going on.
But those two beautiful kids now are going to grow up with nuts.
They have kids
but
together.
Then,
I think the main focus is supposed to be the kids.
Really, let's talk about the time that guy took to like get his lawyers, put everything in the mommy's names. Yeah, like that guy, like we are in a relationship, probably we're having some conflicts and fighting. You're busy behind me putting all the property in your mommy's. That means none of them is right.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe she was playing something as he's spying.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
The end game ended whereby he was smart.
While we're separating.
But also,
yeah.
I've followed Hakimi for
like
some time.
It's like a concept, you get it?
Yeah.
It doesn't happen in one day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But also, I've followed Hakimi for some time. This guy has a strong relationship with his mother.
We all have relationships with our parents.
Yeah, but they,
but this
they
guy,
are
this even the sneakers are in his mommy's names.
Yeah. Because, you know, even it happened even the World Cup. This guy scored a goal and then he went in the crowd to peck his mom,
mm-hmm.
mother.
Because the
but
mom...
I have an idea maybe.
Mm-hmm.
It could be from their background.
Yeah.
Between him and the mother.
And the mother.
Because maybe they survived
You can have a parent, the worst times. But you are not friends with that parent.
Yeah. Very true. Very, very
true. You know that it's possible.
Yeah, very true.
And no, she's not mother, friends with that parent. You don't have that deep connection with your mother.
Mm.
So, in this case, the way I've been looking at this guy scoring goals, even in the crowd, even when they lose games, his mother is always there. Yeah, Gualico, Gualico.
And the wife was also there for him.
She was there, but there's some logic there between him and the wife.
I think these are the ones we term as the baby, the mama's.
We are going to spend the whole day on this topic and we'll never have...
Actually, true.
I mean, like a mutual understanding because, I mean, we reason differently. By the end of the day...
Because you're not the ones who are there. Yeah.
By the end of the day, I would advise fellow women. Yeah, like when you're in a relationship, don't leave a guy or divorce him because you want to take his property or you want to share, or like the wife wanted to share. Like how Benny said, like... You're in love, that time you're not thinking about property. You're thinking about the feelings that you have for each other. So I would never be like on the side of the lady because, I mean, she said she wanted all after their divorce. Like, did she plan? Like, yeah. After some years, this is what is going to happen? Probably, and the guy saw it and planned. But at the end of the day, still do not be in a relationship. And then when you're divorcing, you don't have anything that, I mean, like, you're living for the lady or...
At least you give her like a 20%
at least.
Yeah, even if you don't have kids.
Yeah, it's true.
Yes, even if you don't have kids. But I've been in a relationship before where we had to separate and then we couldn't even say hi to each other or even talk like how we seated here.
Just blocked him even.
We blocked each other. So there will never be a good way to separate. Yeah. Yes.
Okay, no, I think that's enough with property sharing because at the end of the day, whether we speak about it or we notice, it all goes back to down to the couples, what you decide to do.
As ladies, we are going to start going to the shops with you guys while we're buying a thing on buying a property and then you put my name on the list. I mean,
so when you're divorcing, you'll be like, bro, my name is on the receipt, so it's mine. Okay.
Yeah, it should change to the kids.
Yes.
Actually,
the
true.
Parents should start buying stuff in their children's names because we are too, like, we're doing it for the kids. Yeah. Because when you take it as you, maybe I might feel somehow, and if I take it as me, you might feel someone. But
if you put it in the kid's name, then you know it's either yours. Okay, it's both yours and hers. And so it's all.
Because all the hassle, all the security that we're trying to put around is for the children to live a better life. We are adults, we are grown. So it's not about fighting for me, it's fighting for the family.
Okay, I think that's enough for property sharing because, like I said, at the end of the day, it's between the couples, what you decide. Because there are those that do not want, that just want the man for the man. It's just there for love.
Talk about the childhood trauma. Everything comes at a cost.
Yeah.
For example, he's very right when he said about maybe he has some past that... is making him all do that, maybe with the mom or with the way that dad treated the mom. So everything, growing up, I grew up from a very beautiful Muslim family, but I never saw a stepmom. So, and now, at my age right now, you can't convince me that a man can have four wives. So, these things, sometimes we see them while we're growing up. Up now, people will try to convince me, oh, you're a Muslim, and... it's okay for your boyfriend or your husband to have more than one wife. Up to now, at my age, you cannot convince me that my husband has to be with another woman because of what I grew up seeing.
This comes from my very question. Since you guys have kids, but you are not in a legal marriage, most cases right now, I'm going to term in Ugandan setting, we have divorce, but not in terms of marriage or you went to the bill. We have divorce in a sense of, I'm in love with someone, we are staying together, we end up having a child, and now things don't work out the way we thought, we are separated. It's no longer separation if it involves a kid, it's now divorce.
I'm
calling it divorce, because that is how it is. Yeah. So that comes to my question of, do you think children that comes from damaged homes or half homes, do you think that affects the way they think in the future?
Yeah, a lot.
Why do you think that?
Because it's, you give what you get.
Mm-hmm.
You can't love when you've never been loved before.
That's true. Very many people actually out there, they do not know what love is. And let us first go for a commercial break. When we come back, we are going to be tackling the topic of love in divorce. Like, how does divorce affect the people who are here right now? And how does divorce affect also the parents themselves in terms of getting a connection with their children? Let us go to for a short commercial break. When we come back, we are still talking about it.